Good day. If you're new to the channel, welcome. I'm T-Mac, and I help pilots like you start and continue their journey to better FPV fun through the Fast Track FPV course, videos like this one, and my site at tmacfpv.com. I also design frames for, build, and fly micro FPV drones, which are those that spin 4-inch props or less. By now you may have heard about the FAA's new rule on remote ID. If not, no worries. Today I'm going to give you a very quick and simple to understand graphical summary that you can download and print out for yourself from a link in the video description below on how remote ID may affect both the building and operation of micro FPV quadcopters, which are just one type of RC model aircraft the FAA calls unmanned aircraft, and most of the rest of the general population calls drones. Once we know how this new remote ID rule affects pilots who want to start or continue flying micro FPV drones, I'll show you something I've been working on to make it as easy as possible for you to have fun flying FPV and do so legally, without remote ID if you want, even after the remote ID compliance date. Today I'm going to introduce you to something on my tmacfpv.com site, which will walk you through, step by step, everything you need to know to easily make your own home-built, recreational micro FPV drone weighing in at 0.55 pounds or less, like this one, that can fly over 17 minutes without carrying a GoPro, or even over 13 minutes carrying a GoPro, and still come in under that 0.55 pound limit. I think you're going to like this, so make sure to give this video a thumbs up below, share it with as many pilots as you can, and subscribe to your T-Mac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. All right, the new FAA rule on remote ID, 14 CFR Part 89, differentiates between unmanned aircraft weighing over 0.55 pounds all up weight and those 0.55 pounds or less, where all up weight includes everything on board or otherwise attached to the unmanned aircraft. So that's the first question we have to ask ourselves. Is or will our all up weight be equal to or less than 0.55 pounds? If the answer is yes, then we've passed the first hurdle and can go on to the next step. If the answer is no, regardless if we're flying commercially or not, you'll need to register your unmanned aircraft and remote ID will be required. Let's continue with our plan for a home-built micro FPV drone that weighs less than 250 grams. Then our next question is, will we be flying recreationally or commercially? If we're flying recreationally, then we don't even have to register our unmanned aircraft. And remote ID is not required, which makes us very happy. Remember, you can grab this chart if you like to help you remember the remote ID requirements through a link in the video description below. Now let's figure out how we plan our build of a recreational micro FPV drone weighing 0.55 pounds or less. To do that, we go to tmacfpv.com. So we go to the homepage at tmacfpv.com, and here we see the different menu items we can use to jump to any of the pages on the site, to include this button over here, which takes you to the Fast Track FPV course site, where you can look at the course curriculum if you're interested. Today, we want to go to Build Your Own Micro FPV Drone. This first section of the page is where I talk about building your own micro FPV drone is actually easier than you might think it is. Really, the most difficult part is choosing the right components for your build based on how you want to fly it, for what purpose, and keeping your build weight within any established weight limits you may have, such as 0.55 pounds or under 250 grams. Since planning ahead and choosing the right components is such a key aspect of building a micro FPV drone that can be exempt from remote ID, I've organized this page into sections of all the components you need to make your home-built micro FPV drone in the order of which I'd recommend you choosing them, starting with frames. Before clicking on any of these components, what I recommend as a best practice for planning purposes is going to the all-up weight calculator page, which you can either access through this link or scroll down and click on its image down here. Then download the all-up weight calculator so you can fill it out as you choose your components from each of these individual components pages. So we'll jump to the all-up weight calculator page, and up top here, I describe what it is, how to get it, and how to use it for planning purposes. Let me quickly demonstrate. This is what the all-up weight calculator looks like. It's got all of your major components listed over here on the left that are associated with each of the components pages of the site. It even gets down to the battery strap level. Let's go ahead and download it by clicking on this image, or you could click down here on the text underneath it. This brings up the Google Sheets file in view only mode. If you have a Google Drive account, just go over here to File, make a copy, and save it somewhere on your computer. When you open the copied file, choose to enable editing, and you'll then be able to input component weights into these green fields. The way this works is you input the component's weight into these green fields over here, and it automatically copies it over into the second column, with the exception of motors and props. For those components, you only enter the weight of one motor or prop, which is what you'll actually see on their product pages. And when you do that, the all-up weight calculator multiplies that number by 4 and places that resulting value in the second column, highlighted in purple. The number in the blue box down here at the bottom is a running total of your build's all-up weight as you enter each component. So by the time you've selected all of your components, you'll have a very good estimate of your micro FPV drone build's weight before you even start building it. That's a lot better than finding out after you buy components and complete your build that it weighs a few grams too much. If that number in the blue box reaches 250 grams or above, by referring to your remote ID summary chart, recall if you complete the build at that weight, you'll be required to register it and have remote ID. If this isn't something you want to do, perhaps you should pick another component with less weight so your micro FPV drone build falls under that 0.55 pound limit. All right, let's go back to your build your own micro FPV drone page by clicking up here on the menu item. Now that you've got your all-up weight calculator, you're ready to start selecting possible components from each of these sections. I'm not going to go through all of the component sectional pages today, but I will go through just a few, which have tools I think you'll find very useful. Let's start with frames. I formatted each of these component pages similarly, where I give you my thoughts up front based on my experiences and research over the past few years about what you should look for when deciding between different options of the component. After I provide you with my thoughts and experiences, I'll usually have some tools and resources listed for you, such as charts, guides, checklists, and short instructional video clips on the topic. For instance, in this frames component page, I've included a short instructional video on things you should consider when purchasing a frame, along with this micro FPV 3-inch frames guide you can grab over here that compares important parameters of over 60 different 3-inch frames you can choose from, as indicated here on the screen with just a small portion of the frames guide. These micro FPV drone build tools and resources will normally be followed with a list of my favorites and recommendations for that component, along with my thoughts on each item, and links to where you can purchase them. Of course, some of these links are going to be affiliate links, which you can use at no additional cost to you, but will go a long way to support your TMAC FPV channel, and I'd greatly appreciate it. Let's look at a couple tools I've got for you on the motors component page. Here on the motors page, you see I followed the same format with my thoughts and experiences up top, followed by the tools and resources, which are followed by my recommendations. The tools and resources I've included on the motors page include this short video clip on important parameters to consider when choosing motors, and the micro FPV motors chart, which you can grab over here, which I just updated for its 6th edition, comparing important parameters including weight and thrust to weight ratio on over 85 different micro FPV motors, ranging in size from 0.8XX for your whoop type quads to 16XX motors, as depicted on the screen once again in just a small portion of the motors chart. Keep in mind as you choose your components to fill out the weight value in your planned build's all-up weight calculator. Let's see what I have for you on the batteries page. Up top, I explained some things about LiPo batteries and that they're actually the heaviest component, if you will, on your entire quadcopter, so it makes sense to choose them wisely. That's what this page is all about. I mentioned some LiPo battery safe charging procedures I practice, some of which are demonstrated in this video showing how to charge LiPo batteries. Up here, I've got my list of favorite micro FPV drone batteries, but it's more than just a list. When choosing batteries, I calculate a capacity to weight ratio, or the milliamp hour rating, divided by the battery's weight. So down here in my favorites list chart, I've got a column with the battery's capacity, which gives you an indication of how long it'll last. A higher number tends to give you a longer flight time, dependent upon its weight, which is in this next column. Ideally, you want a very lightweight, high-capacity battery. So this next column, capacity to weight ratio, compares those two values in the ratio of capacity to weight. The higher this ratio value, theoretically, the more efficient the battery should be. There are, of course, many other considerations for LiPo batteries, but for me, that's a useful one I wanted to provide you with. Next, I want to take you to the build tips and supplies page. This build tips and supplies page, as you might imagine, has both of those. It's got a list of most of the supplies I use for my builds, and I mention on the page, I don't purchase the most expensive items I can. I go for the best value items. A lot of this stuff is my soldering gear. And the first tip I have for you on this page is a short demonstration on how I solder using these supplies. The one thing I'd like you to get out of this page is soldering is not some mysterious art. I don't have any specialized soldering training. I taught myself in a couple of days. I don't aim to have the prettiest solder joints. I just want them to be functional so I can fly. These tools, supplies, and techniques I use have worked well for me for years. I encourage you to give them a shot. Periodically, I'll be updating the tips on this page, so make sure to come back to it every now and then. I've got one more page I want to introduce you to, and that's the Tune Your Build page. Once you're done with your home-built recreational micro-FPV drone, this is the page for you. Or, even if you have some tuning issues with one of your pre-built bind-and-fly quads, this is for you. I've got a couple tools on this page that'll help you out. The first one is this tuning guide for micro-FPV quadcopters, which you can grab just by clicking on this image or the text below it. The tuning guide describes the general PID tuning process concept graphically through flowcharts. Although initially produced for micro-FPV drones, the concept described applies to all quadcopters that require adjustments to their PID and filter settings from the default Betaflight values, such as micro-FPV drones, low authority CineWhoop type quads, or higher authority quads, since the Betaflight default values are primarily set up for your normal 5-inch freestyle quadcopters. Specific step-by-step procedures to implement these graphical concepts are also specifically detailed in this guide. The second tool I have for you is a 3-part mini-series of video clips with quick and simple steps to tune your micro-FPV drone and demonstrates the use of the PID tuning guide. To access any of these, just click on their images or the text below.
So that's the newest addition to your TMACFPV.com site. Build your own micro-FPV drone. I know you'll find it useful to continue your FPV fun with or without Remote ID. Let me know what you think in the comments below. I'm looking forward to making continuous and helpful improvements to it for you, so if you've got some suggestions, put those down there too, or just shoot me an email at tmac@tmacfpv.com. I hope to hear from you soon. Until then, thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.